Hello everybody, my name is Tumu Tuine, and today I'm here with my father, Tom Tuine.
Hello.
He's been a member and a worker for the Hawaii Stephen Division ILWU for about 14 years now, and I'm going to ask him a few questions about his job. So tell me, how has the ILWU impacted the lives of the members and their families?
Oh, well. First of all, I'm very grateful for the ILWU and the union because they impacted us on a huge, very huge. But first of all, I want to thank the brothers and the sisters that came before us, because literally we stand on the shoulders of giants that came before us. You know, like the Harry Kamokus, the Jack Halls, Hubert Kanahas, and all the other members. These are the ones that through their blood, sweat, and tears, that they are able to fight and get us where we are today. And by what I mean by where we are today is fair wages, safe working conditions, good benefits, because it always wasn't like that. It wasn't just handed to us. They had to fight for it, and through their blood, their sweat, and their tears, they fought for it. And first, they ask for these things. You know, we ask, can we have fair wages? Can we have better medical? Mm-hmm. And every time the employer kept on shutting them down, said, no, this is what you have, take it or leave it, get out of here. They was just treated so unfairly, to eventually they had to demand to be treated fairly. They had to demand some rights. So what happened was that they had to get a union. They had to get the voice of all employees to get the word around so we can stand together. And that's just basically how the ILWU is formed, the Local 142. We had to get the guys, all the employees, to come together as one voice, one message, and together when we stand strong, the employers, the ones who had the product, they had no choice but to listen. But it wasn't easy. Like, for example, the Hilo massacre, I think it was back in, see, I might have the date a little bit wrong, 1938 or so, like that. The Hilo massacre, that was one of the big stands that they made, that the people stood for their rights and they striked. Mm-hmm. They demanded some fair wages.
They did all this because before, back in the day, they were treated unequally?
Unequally. The wages was like, it was so minimal. You can get hurt on a job. They basically just pushed you on the side and called for the next guy to come in. Uh-huh. If you talk back to one of the owners of the shipping thing, knowing that something's wrong, if you voiced any kind of concern, they just got rid of you. The worker had no rights whatsoever. And so what they did was they made a stand. And what happened was, it's kind of interesting too, because these guys were unarmed. They came and they protested, but peacefully. And what happened was that the owners, the employers, they got the local authorities involved. They brought the tear gas to those guys. They shot them down with water. They ended up opening fire on them. It's still a bullet. They used these bird shell bullets, where a lot of it like BBs, just spreads out and on. They opened fire against these unarmed U.S. Not U.S. citizens at that time, unarmed citizens. Of the workers, they just opened up and some got hurt, and unfortunately, nothing happened after. It took years and years till the stuff started to fall into place. But fast track to where we are today, through strikes, through protests, through demanding.
Came a long way.
Yes. Yeah. So now we have good benefits. Mm-hmm. I have because of them, I have I can provide for my family. I have a roof over my head. Food on the table, get clothes for their families, education. You have a great education. And this was all came from the brothers and the sisters of the ILWU.
Mm-hmm. It's interesting how they all came from from nothing to something. And I guess you think the process that the ILWU went through, you think that shaped your character, made you who you are today as a better person?
Yes. Yes, because you have that camaraderie,
right,
among each other.
Yeah.
I'm very proud when we have, and I say that in a humble way, And when we come to work, we're very close to everybody. Mm-hmm. Everybody, we start the day off when we first check in for work. Everybody giving each other a handshake and saying how the thing's going, what we're gonna have for how the family's going. There's a bond there.
So it's definitely a job you enjoy doing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's how it's supposed to be. You're supposed to find a job that you really love and it means something deep to you.
Right. I enjoy work. And one thing too, as a way of thanking the guys who came before us, and I'm a firm believer in is that we should don't forget the guys who came before us, the pensioners. Mm-hmm. So we try to, in our contracts that come up, we always try to make sure that we take care of some of the pensioners as we go along. Because
how do you guys take care of them? What are some examples that you guys do?
The retirement fund, first of all. We try to make sure that the pension fund that it's going into invested correctly, so we can take care of when you get retirement. Because one of the things that and this is not only for the ILWU, this is the nation as a whole. We forget that we should be celebrating the elderly, mm-hmm. because they went through a lot of the hard times in life. They've been through there, and then through their blood, sweat, and tears, they became the older people. And we should look up to them, and as a whole, we should take better care of them. And so the pension is one of the ways we do it. We have a panel now that we just newly formed for this last contract, where we have a panel of paid professionals that are going to invest the money that we put in, which is a very good thing.
Interesting. So from when you first started working at Hawaii Stevedores and fast forward to now, you're in a different position as you were in the beginning. Has anything changed from when you first started to now? As in the environment or the way how people work? Has it grown positively or negatively? Or
no,
the same?
My personal opinion, it's grown positively.
Yeah, but it's been 15 years. Yeah, and right. You've been a small chunk of the growing process of it.
Right, and then I remember one of the old timers when I first started inside there, and I just got hired. Probably was either my first or maybe even my second year, and he told me, "Hey boy, the best advice I can give you is you try to make the union better than when you first got in.
Right.
So by the time you retire, you look back and you say that if you made it better." Or if you do nothing to it, which you always want to see improvement, and it did, and I believe I've done it. I've helped make it a better union than when I first was got in. When I first got in, it was good already.
Yeah.
But you want to keep the thing going. You don't want to become complacent and everything. Mm-hmm. So as we go in time like that, and we improved, and a lot of it, a lot of times you can just look at the benefits. Mm-hmm. It's a good a sign of how the thing is, and right now we're our benefits is good. It's good, and the environment is great. The working conditions have improved. I meant the safety conditions as well. Mm-hmm. So I think that's my goal, always to make sure it's into better than when I came in there. And I know I said this earlier, is just don't forget about the guys who came before me, because that's really, really vital.
On the shoulders of giants.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. It's like just thinking about your kupunas and all that. Right. So don't forget them. Don't forget mm-hmm. the elderly, because that's what got us here.
Thank you. Well, I appreciate you sharing your experience with us. Do you have any last comments or any other remarks you want to add?
That I'm a. I love my job where I'm at. I believe in the unity. I believe what we stand for. I believe we stand for the working class. I believe the working class has a voice, and we should be heard because we're the ones that move the product. Mm-hmm. One of the biggest things I'm very, very thankful for is that the best way to show my thankfulness is to do my best job when I'm at the waterfront. Because when I, and that's not even what the main thing I'm thankful for. The main thing I'm thankful for is that the ILWU, the union, provided for my family. Mm-hmm. I'm working, but when I'm working, I provide for my family. I provided for you, provided for your mom, right. I provided for my kids, and that's what, and just able to have like decent education, a better education, food on the table, roof over your head, transportation, right. Just all these things is that I'm very grateful for that, and that's the only way you can be thankful for it is by your work performance. Mm-hmm. And that's what I always keep in my head there. I'm on the waterfront for our job, first and foremost, but the main thing is providing for my family. And that's one of the best things I have. So, and I just want to add also that I didn't apply for this scholarship earlier because for some reason I didn't apply to one of my friends told me that he said that's one of the things that they wanted to do. It was made for this, to help out the families of the ILWU. So right. I just came and applied it for this year for you.
Well, thank you. Thank you for your words and your experience with the ILWU. That sums up our interview. Again, this is my dad, Tom Tuine. I'm Tumu Tuine, and hopefully one day I can follow my dad's footsteps and work for ILWU and the Hawaii Stevedores. Thank you, and mahalo.
Aloha.